And now, Michigan Voices of the War.
Tokyo was my first major mission, and it was going to be an incendiary bombing mission. You could see the fires 200 miles out when you were coming in. We were hit in the right inboard engine, and the fire was very bad. I made sure my chute was hatched, and I dove headfirst out that beautiful open bomb bay door. Now, I know everybody who watches POW movies, they think about the cots along the wall, you know, and the little round stove and the guys sitting around playing cards and trying to figure out how they're going to escape. Well, none of that happens here. They tied me up to a clothesline, like a cross, and they all made bayonet runs at me, and the last one stuck me in the neck here and stuck me up through the mouth, and they were quite happy about that. All the farmers' wives and all the kids came out and were giggling and throwing stones. Kempei Tai, a house of horrors, a house of torture. Everything you did was for a torturous reason. You get up at 5 o'clock in the morning, you can't talk to anyone. People who have talked in their cell were immediately shot. They took all my clothes but my OD shorts. No water, no toilet, no nothing. You did everything right there. I never washed. All the time I was in there, never washed my hands, never brushed my teeth. Beatings took place daily. They all carry kindle sticks. They're like short baseball bats. They're made out of bamboo, and they whack you with them. Every time you went out to be interrogated, you had to put on your sandals. Every time you put on your sandals, you knew what was going to happen. You're going to get whacked right across the back, just as hard as they can hit. Now, what do we get for food? Well, from May until September, I had one fish head bone and I had one green tomato. When I left, I weighed less than 100 pounds. They said I 87, but I think I weighed 93 pounds. The night was the worst. There would be this moans and groans. The sounds are a result of the doctors treating people, of people dying with amoebic dysentery. You just prayed that the good Lord would take them fast. To let people die like this is just beyond my ability to think about it. When we got up in the morning, Higgins' boats came in, those boats that dropped down in front, and the Marines were on them. They come in all with their gear, and a man came in and tapped me on the shoulder, and he said, "Get this guy out of here." My wife and I, we went up in an airplane. We finally landed on the same island that I was shot down from. That was my closure.